of the store.
And did you, in fact, sell him something there?
I did.
Do you recall what it was that you sold to him?
A pack of cigarettes.
Right. You saw you reach over to your left. Is that where the cigarettes are stored?
Yes.
And so had he already told you at that point what he wanted?
Yes.
Right. And so you didn't have any difficulty understanding what he wanted to buy from you?
No.
And then did you complete that transaction?
Yes.
And after that, what did Mr. Floyd do?
He then went back outside to his vehicle.
All right. So we'll let this run then to its end. Now, if I freeze it here, sorry, I said I was going to let it run, but we saw you holding something up. Can you describe, and again for the record, this is 7:45:10, describe for the jurors what you were doing there.
I was holding up the $20 bill that I just received.
And is that something you always do, or something about this?
No. When I saw the bill, I noticed that it had a blue pigment to it, kind of how a $100 bill will have. And I found that odd, so I assumed that it was fake.
Okay. But Mr. Floyd is still there, correct?
Yes.
And you completed the transaction?
Yes.
All right. And then upon doing that, did he leave the store?
Yes.
All right. So now let's let that run, please. So after you looked at the bill, though, he didn't leave immediately, did he?
No.
All right, so that is the end of Exhibit 29, I believe the time there is 7:45:51, correct? Well, I'm asking you, but you saw that on the timestamp on there.
Correct.
So we could look at other video to determine if that time is correct. That's the time he left the store on this video.
Yes.
All right. After he left, did you look at the bill again?
I did.
At the time that you were working on May 25th of 2020, what was the store policy about cashiers accepting $20 bills?
The policy was that if you took a counterfeit bill, you would have to pay for it out of your money or your paycheck.
It gives you an incentive to be careful about what you take.
Yes.
All right. So did you think that bill might not be legitimate?
I did.
So what did you decide to do?
I took it anyways, and I was planning to just put it on my tab until I second-guessed myself. And as you can see in the video, I kept examining it, and then I eventually told my manager.
All right. And when you told your manager, what happened next? What were you told to do?
He told us to go out to the vehicle and to ask him to come inside to discuss what just happened.
And when you say vehicle, what are you referring to?
The car, or the SUV, I think, that George Floyd was in.
How did you know that?
I could see it from where I was standing in tobacco from the store.
So we know from the video that those windows we could see where that bus was, that's actually Chicago, correct?
Yes.
38th runs along the backside of that store.
Yes.
Is there a way to look then out on the 38th from the store?
Yes.
And I guess what I'm questioning is, how did you know he was in that vehicle?
I watched him walk to it.
Pretty good way to know.
Yes.
And so you saw him go out to that vehicle after he made this purchase?
Yes.
And so your manager, what were your instructions?
Just to go out to the vehicle and ask him to come inside to talk to the manager.
And did you, in fact, do that?
Yes.
All right. When you went out there, let me ask you this. How many times did you go out there?
Twice.
So let's talk about the first time that you went out there. Did you go by yourself or with some other people?
The first time I went with one other person.
And you are aware that there is a security video on the restaurant across the street, correct?
Yes.
That's the Dragon Walk was the restaurant?
Yes.